Right now, we are in the Grossman Mineral Museum in Earth and Planetary Sciences building. That's in Rudolph Hall. But there's another very fun thing that people can look at just across the hall from us, the fluorescent mineral display, where ultraviolet light activates fluorescence on a large number of minerals. There are a lot of samples from northern New Jersey, Franklin and Sterling Hill, New Jersey. This is a zinc mine. And I actually became interested in those particular rocks when I was in high school. I thought fluorescence was a neat thing I'd heard about, read about. And here it turned out the fluorescent mineral capital of the world was just a couple hours drive away in New Jersey. And so I started at a very young age being interested in these rocks. And I was lucky over the intervening years to be able to go underground several times. And I remember at one point having so much of the ore in my backpack that a colleague had to reach over. I was actually getting pulled backward to fall down into a rather large pit, and he grabbed me just in time before I fell in. So I ended up with quite a good bit of material over the years. So as you press the button and you activate the ultraviolet light, you'll see all these colors. They're different colors from the way the sample looked under original incandescent light, but they're also colors that differ from each other. So we're talking about having some light source, some excitation that hits the mineral, and then inside of the mineral we have atoms, and they have electrons at different levels of energy. And so this incoming light is actually a form of energy, and it pops some of the electrons to a higher state. And when they drop down, they actually have to give off a packet of energy that represents the difference between the energy level where they began and where they hopped up to. For those different minerals, those energy levels will be different, so you could see how you might get some different colors. The other thing is more has to do with how fluorescence occurs. Our minerals are geological, natural samples, and so they typically have various elements in them at small concentrations in addition to the main elements. In some cases, one of those elements acts as what we call an activator. It is what actually is causing the fluorescence to occur. So there are different activating elements in the different minerals that you are looking at, and then the minerals themselves are different. And so those combinations then give you the different colors that you see.